lastly, thank God for all the blessings we enjoy as Americans, including the blessing of democracy. And we all join in that prayer of thanksgiving, I know. My personal prayer of thanksgiving revolves around two things. First and foremost, the boundless love and support of a wonderful, wonderful family. Many of them are here with us tonight. I'm honored by that. Includes Wendy and my siblings and their spouses and cousins, and obviously includes our four children. But that team is led by an unbelievable spouse, an unbelievable full partner in life in everything I do, Wendy. My other prayer of thanksgiving is about all of you. You know, after the love of my family, the greatest honor I have ever enjoyed is to serve you as our U.S. Senator, and I really mean that. And Wendy and I are so grateful, not just for this victory, not just for your votes and support, but on a much more personal level, we are so grateful for your generous spirit, for your well wishes, for your friendship, for your prayers that we have felt every step of the way, particularly in the last few years. Thank you for being there always for us. We are so very grateful. I decided over a year ago that I could never express that gratitude adequately in words. And so I decided I would have to keep trying to express it every day by getting up and acting and working on your behalf. And that's how I'm going to keep trying to express that unbelievable gratitude, by fighting for you every day, by listening, and not just listening, but hearing and giving voice to all of us, by working hard, and not just working hard, but fighting and never, ever letting up on the key issues that we face as a country and as Louisiana. And so I'll keep doing that in a second Senate term. I'll keep demanding that we have the coastal restoration and hurricane and flood protection we need from the Corps of Engineers and others. I'll keep fighting for that full recovery from the hurricanes, from the oil disaster that we need here in Louisiana. And nationally, I'll keep demanding that on national issues, I'll keep demanding that we come together and get this spiraling spending and debt under control so our kids have a future. I'll remind my colleagues that we need real job creation, and that starts in the private sector and small business, folks who know how to grow jobs, not on the government side. And I'll keep fighting and giving voice to you on health care, too. We need real, targeted health care reform, and that starts with the outright repeal of Obamacare. Thank all of you for all of your love and support. That's my commitment. But I think we all want to join together tonight in a new commitment to the future. And that really is represented by our kids. Wendy and I are blessed to have four great kids, Sophie and Lise and Ari and Jack. They're our inspiration. But all of us have that sort of inspiration, kids or grandkids or godchildren or neighbors and nieces and nephews. And that ultimately is what it is all about, So tonight, let's come together and recommit all of our efforts to them. Let's rediscover our better angels with them, and let's reclaim our country, our greatness, and their future. Thank you all very much.